Josh, you contacted me about co-hosting when you heard about what happened to Sempe.
Of course.
And you said that you had a lot you wanted to say about Dynamite and something else as well, I forgot. But I know it was Dynamite.
Buddy Murphy.
Buddy Murphy. Oh, yeah, let's talk about Buddy Murphy. Then we'll get into Dynamite. What do you have to say about Buddy Murphy, of all things?
So, you know, all the releases last week, big surprise, obviously. And there's kind of so many different ways of thinking, right? Everyone's thinking, you know, Aleister Black, AEW makes a good fit. You know, we'll talk about Andrade, I'm sure, a little bit later. You know, David, some thoughts about that, which I kind of disagree with in terms of how that went on Friday. So everyone's kind of like, well, let's slot this person here. Let's slot this person here and so on. If I'm Buddy Murphy, and then where does this even kind of the people that just got released, what, 3 weeks ago, whatever it was during the NXT cuts. If I'm Buddy Murphy, I might think about just doing the indies for a year and really creating a huge buzz for myself, kind of like what Drew McIntyre did back in the day that is mentioned quite a bit. Just travel around. Don't just kind of slot into whatever the easiest spot is, but literally like do the Cody Rhodes thing, work, make the list, work around the world. All these places are opening up again. Indies are back. Going to be a fun summer. Just work. Go work and have fun and kind of reinvigorate yourself, endear yourself to new fans, new crowds. Be the star of every high-level indie show you can. And then, you know, raise your price a little bit so a year from now, you know, next Labor Day, you'll be able to maybe write your own ticket or maybe just stick with what you're doing. And I think it's sometimes easy to go with the Impact, the AEW, whatever maybe offers you the first thing, but maybe does everything a little bit different because this whole group just got released. They're going to be thinking maybe the same thing.
I'll tell you what I think this bloke should do. This guy needs to go to New Japan, and I'll tell you why I think he needs to go to New Japan. A lot of problems in New Japan right now. A lot of it is pandemic related. But they just lost their IWGP World Heavyweight Champion, Will Ospreay. He's gone back to the UK and whatever's going on there. And there's a couple of other names of other foreigners who are not on this tour. And Jay White is one of them. And David Finlay is another one of them. And David Finlay's father did an interview and flat out said maybe David Finlay's days here may be numbered. He's going to start. He may be looking for things to do elsewhere. I mean, El Fantasmo's on the tour, but I think his deal is either up or it might be up soon. Fact of the matter is, at this exact moment, they're down at least three foreigners. And with Buddy Murphy, I mean, Buddy Murphy could walk into New Japan tomorrow and be awesome. And they need foreign talent right now. And he would have great matches, and he would make a name for himself. And he doesn't need what he doesn't have here in this country, which is a sparkling personality and fantastic promos. All he needs to do in New Japan, for the most part, is work. I mean, if he can speak any language, he can do the promos. I mean, it's not like they're going to push you or not push you based on whether or not you're a good promo. So that, I think, is the best place for him to be right now. And if he goes to New Japan, he can work shows in America with the different promotions that New Japan is working for right now. He can do New Japan Strong. He can do Shots for Impact. If he ends up in America for New Japan Strong, he could probably work a match or two on Dynamite without signing. That is, I think, where this guy should go now. But I guess we'll see.
Yeah, but who knows when Japan's going to open up, right? I mean, possible it could be, you know, it could be Labor Day. That's when his 90-day non-compete is up, so that's possible. But, yeah, I think it just depends on what are his goals, right? I mean, not just thinking short-term, but long-term. He's done WWE thing. He kind of checked that off the list. But, yeah, does he want to travel? It's hard to know because we don't know so much about these guys' personal lives and things that they want to accomplish, things that they haven't accomplished. You know, maybe he wants to do some teaching in school. Who knows? But, it's such an interesting time because you have all these guys are going to be free agents impending. We have Impact teasing a bunch of them coming to Slammiversary. Who knows there? We have more could come at any time, as we've seen. We didn't expect Braun Strowman and that group to get released last week. So it's a very interesting time. There's a lot of different places to work, but where's your biggest opportunity going to be? And that's obviously a big question with AEW as well, or WWE, people that sign there. Where's your biggest opportunity going to be? Where's the path of least resistance to the top spot? And for a lot of these places, the rosters are so packed that you really have to kind of take pause and think, like, is this going to be good short-term, long-term, and what are my goals and what I want to do?
Should mention that tonight we have got a decision match for the IWGP World Heavyweight Championship with Shingo Takagi taking on the man who hates the belt and thinks it's a stupid idea and is upset about the way that they handled everything in Okada. And I don't know who's going to win. I mean, honestly, at this point, it could go to either guy, and I would be cool with it. I'm hoping that Okada wins and throws down the belt and proclaims himself the IWGP champion again and gets rid of this new belt and tries to go back to the old lineage. I don't think it's going to happen, but that's coming up tonight, everybody. And we'll talk about it on the show tomorrow. Do you have a pick? Do you watch any New Japan, Josh?
I don't. I'm familiar with what's going on with Strong, but not as much the New Japan proper. But what I do know is obviously what I hear on Wrestling Observer Radio and other places that they don't really have the mojo they used to anymore. And they kind of need to get it back. So maybe that instead of going the Shingo route, perhaps they go back to the old hand, as it were, with Okada. And, you know, just as we see what happens, you know, we saw with Flair for so many years that no matter what, sometimes you go back to the people that you trust over and over and over again. And I wouldn't be surprised to see Okada get again. But if they want it, if they're like, look, business is going to be down for the next 3 months, 6 months, 5 months, why don't we do an experimental champion? But they kind of did that with Evil, right? So maybe they don't want to do that again. But I would expect Okada because why not?
Bert says, I want Shingo to win. He deserves it. Well, it's not about deserved, everybody. Listen, if all things were equal, I would love to see Shingo as the champion. But at the end of the day, they're in the middle of a pandemic, and they had a bunch of shows this month that had to be canceled, including a Tokyo Dome show. And what they need is a champion who could have money-drawing matches with challengers. And if you look at the challengers lined up, Okada is probably going to draw better as champion against all of those guys. So for business purposes, he's probably the right pick, but I would not have a problem with Shingo as champion. If you enjoy these videos, for just $7.99 per month, you can enjoy full-length editions of The Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, Figure Four Daily with Tom Lawler and Lance Storm, plus hundreds of archived shows, all in beautiful HD. Don't miss out. Join us today.